Today, I'll be having a roundtable discussion with Colgate and the Cybersmile Foundation.
But, you know, bullying has changed, and we just experience it on such a scale that is so different than what it used to be in the past. And that's what this roundtable is going to be all about. We want to really talk about what is cyberbullying, how prevalent it is in young people, and what we can all do to be really good digital allies. And look, Alisha, like, you know, we've chatted about this before, but, you know, there's going to be people that'll be like, wait a minute, she's beautiful, she's famous, like, how can she understand? You know, have you, like, share with us, have you experienced cyberbullying yourself? And, you know, if you feel comfortable, can you share your experience and how it made you feel?
Absolutely. I wish I thought of myself that way, but the way you introduced me, thank you so much. I could split my life up with different social media platforms that were popular at the time, from when I was elementary school till now, and I'm 24. So, of course, the internet brings a lot of good, great things and connections with, like, people, but it also comes with, like, a fair share of mean comments. And when I was in high school and middle school, I would definitely get bullied online. And that only opened up more once I became more of, like, a public figure when I was 19 years old. And I would get mostly good comments, but I got a lot of mean comments as well, which was really overwhelming, especially when you're 19 and you don't know how to navigate that, how to process that, what that does to your self-esteem. And honestly, it made me lose my self-esteem for a while there until I reached out to my support system, which are my friends and my family, and talked to them about it. And I had to personally unplug for a while. I had to build myself back up and remind myself what is important, what is real, what values do I hold, and to understand that their opinion of me is not a reflection of who I truly am.
Alisha, thank you for telling us about your experiences. That feeling of losing self-esteem is really hard, and you don't deserve that. You're not to blame. It wasn't about you. But I wondered if, because a lot of people, they face this kind of thing, and like we talked about for a minute, they don't know if they should tell people and they're not sure where to turn. So I wondered if you ever approached the person who was doing this and kind of pushed back, or if you went to your parent and asked for advice, or if you used any of the tools that are available online. What did you do when this happened to you and you were feeling those hard things?
When I was younger, I definitely was still trying to navigate it. I will admit I wasn't comfortable, or I wasn't as clear with communication as I am now, of course, when you're young. So the first thing I did was ask myself, why is this happening? Kind of blame myself. And then the second that I reached out to my friends, I was reminded, like, oh, this has nothing to do with me. This is completely separate from me. And then it created this safe space and dialogue that I just became more comfortable as I grew to open up to people. And I'm just gonna echo, like, that's what's been my constant theme, is when I'm feeling low, I really reach out to my support system.
A few more stats, because this was, I found this a little bit shocking as well, but back to this report, one of the questions that we asked was, what are people bullied on? And this was a little surprising, because, spoiler alert, it's everything. So, you know, 78% of people said they're bullied on gender identity. 78% of people said religious beliefs. 77% sexual identity, 74% physical or mental ableness, 73% skin tone. So what this kind of told me was that it's broad, like, it's everybody. Anybody that you feel might be slightly different than you for whatever reason, they could be targeted for bullying. And, you know, and Alisha, this is, you know, we chatted on this as well, but, you know, both of, you know, all three of us, you know, we're women, but you and I are both also biracial. And so would love to, like, understand from you, like, have you ever been bullied on because of your identity? And once again, like, you know, tell us, how did you handle it, and what was it?
Absolutely. I think in the world, it's hard being a woman in the society, let alone a woman of color, and it's no different on the internet, if not amplified. I think I've been bullied or had a mean comment or weird DM about any little thing or feature that's a physical attribute of mine, which, I'm not gonna lie, made me feel like, oh, maybe I should angle my face this way or do that, or just be so overly mindful of how I presented myself online because of these people would remind me of certain things that they didn't like about me. And it almost makes you feel like, oh my gosh, I can't do anything without being judged. And I've been bullied from anything about my hair to my nose to, you know, my weight or any physical attribute. And yes, it makes me feel self-conscious, but then I have that second voice in my mind being like, you know, I have to remind myself of what I like about myself and know that really matters and it's not a reflection on me.
I'm so grateful that you're willing to talk about this because, Dana, all those stats that you gave us show us everybody gets bullied about the very things that make us individuals. And Alisha, that feeling of self-consciousness that you describe is hard because it can pop up and bother you at the hardest, most frustrating times when you're really in the zone, really enjoying what you're doing. It is not your fault. It's not your job to have your body shape please somebody else. And it's not your responsibility. But what we forget so often is that the target can't do anything about this. When people attack and harass others online, they're not telling us anything about the target. They're telling us a lot about themselves. They're showing us their bias, their perceptions, their anger, often their own discontent. And it's really important that we point out to people who've been targeted over and over again to be as strong a voice as the aggressor to say, not your fault. Not about you. You're pretty amazing. You deserve a lot of empathy and support. We have to keep in mind when we see cyberbullying happening that yes, it can be really damaging to the target, but kind words and reaching out can actually negate some of that negative and make people feel more positive.
I'd love to hear about, you know, how have you navigated, like when you've witnessed something, like you've witnessed something going down and you're like, I don't really like, that doesn't seem too good. So how have you supported others or how have you contributed to us kind of picking up this trash offline or online?
I am a proud muter, blocker, reporter. And I mean that in the sense of like, I will go down an Instagram rabbit hole. I'll be on like someone's second cousin twice removed Instagram page and then see someone comment kind of something really disgusting or rude and I'll report it. And I'm not even a part of that world even, but even with my page or anything, I'll report comments I see on my page that are hurtful or mean, on my friends' pages. I'll block people who make me feel bad about myself. I'll mute people that doesn't make me feel positive feelings when I'm looking at my feed. So I'm an avid user of all the resources that are on social media. And I'm definitely going to actively pick up the litter on our social media pages and live vicariously like that to try to spread more joy and pleasantries online.
I absolutely love that. I believe it in you. So coming out of today's chat, like, how do you plan to continue to bring more positivity into the digital world?
Well, thank you guys so much for your time, first of all. I love this discussion. I learned a lot. Definitely had a different perspective on how I can move forward in this digital space. I plan on being more active online with, you know, spreading positivity, like, you know, using my platform for these types of things to raise awareness and to speak to wonderful people like yourselves, to reach out to people if I see someone that's maybe struggling or might need some extra support, and continuing my tirade of blocking and muting and reporting.
And so, Dr. G, you're gonna close us out. Any last tips for people on cyberbullying?
I want to go back to this thing that you've talked about a lot, Dana, and just remind people that when you see negative things happening, if you're the target, it's not about you, but your feelings deserve support. And when you see hard things happening online, things that you think are just not supportive, remember that you can step away if that's what you need to do, and you can be the antidote sometimes. You can spread that little positivity that Alisha is talking about. Your actions can have amazing power at helping or even saving someone else.
A big virtual party clap to both the lovely and talented Alisha Boe and the amazing Dr. G. Alisha, thank you for hosting us. Look, Cybersmile is a wonderful foundation, and just to help you kind of get in the groove of supporting them, is for every Co by Colgate product that you purchase through 2021, we will be donating $1 for every product that is purchased, and that we're trying to get to a minimum 200,000 but a maximum 300,000. And thank you, Alisha, thank you, Dr. G. Everybody, you know, have a good night, a good morning, a good afternoon, wherever you're at. Really, thanks a lot.
Thank you guys. Thank you.